We're live. Hey everybody, how's it going? All right, here we go. I'm here in the back room in my house. I'm trying to make this thing get off the screen because who knows how to work stuff, technology. All right, I've got my guitar. This is an old guitar, which means that now and again it makes all sorts of cracks and hisses and weird noises, but that's the beauty of a vintage instrument. We can get into more of that sometime. But here we are, lesson one. I hope everybody is okay at home, all around the world, wherever you are. I'm sending you so much love. It's a weird time, but I really hope you're all right. And I thought this is something I could sort of throw in for everybody to stay busy with. If you play guitar, if you don't play guitar, if you've been playing guitar for ages, or if you've been playing for 5 minutes, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to try and break down some of these songs in all their detail, but also sort of kind of simply as well, and hopefully it will make some kind of sense. Song one, lesson one. I'm going to start with my song Let It Go. If you know it, cool. If you don't, here it is. I'm going to play it for you, and then we'll dive into it. All right. Here we go, wish me luck. From walking home and talking loads to seeing shows in evening clothes with you. Nervous touch and getting drunk, to staying up and waking up with you. Now we're sleeping at the edge, holding something we don't need, and all this delusion in our heads is gonna bring us to our knees. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Don't you be you, and that'll be me, and everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze, and why don't you be you, oh, and I'll be me, yeah, I'll be me. Then why are we doing and doing and doing it anymore? I used to recognize myself. It's funny how reflections change. When we're becoming something else, I think it's time to walk away. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you, and I'll be me, and everything that's wrong, leave it to the breeze, and why don't you be you, when I'll be me, yeah, I'll be me. Force on earth, make it feel right, no. Oh, oh. Trying to push this problem up the hill when it's just too heavy to hold. I think now's the time to let it slide. So come on, let it go, and just let it be. Oh, why don't you be you, And I'll be me and everything that's wrong. Leave it to the breeze. Let the ashes fall. Forget about me. Come on, let it go. Just let it be. And why don't you be you? Oh, now I'll be me. Yeah, I'll be me. So there it is. That's Let It Go. That's me doing it solo, just on a guitar on my own. But let me try and break it down for you and tell you what's going on, what I'm doing. For any of you that know the record version, the version of Chaos and the Calm, there's a few more bits that you couldn't hear there because it's just me and a guitar. But I'll break those down for you and show you what's going on. I'll take you through like the verse and the chorus and the middle eight and the pre-chorus. There's four different sections in that respect, and there's different things to play. I've got a little script down here. You'll see me like look to the side because I'm terrible at talking live to people off the cuff, having not rehearsed it. Okay, so the breakdown starts with the tuning, actually. I think the smartest thing to do, and I'm going to try and show you the whole neck on this sort of tight angle that we're working with here. I'll try and show you everything as we go. But what I do, and there are different ways to go at this, but I actually tune the guitar down what is called a whole step or a whole tone. So a guitar is usually tuned, the strings are E, A, D, G, B, E, but I tune them, all of them down a whole tone. So it goes, I'll try and get this right, what do we do? D, and the A goes down to a G, and the D string goes down to a C, and the G string goes down to an F, and the B string goes down to an A, and the high E string goes down to a D. So it's down a whole step. I just do that because I like the sort of deeper sound. I generally get a slightly deeper sound. I've done it forever, since way before I wrote Let It Go. I guess I like playing sort of open chord shapes like this. That looks like a C chord to everybody who knows about C chords, but it's actually a B flat when the song is tuned down, when the guitar is tuned down, because I guess I sing better in B flat, for example. Anyway, I'm going to try on all occasions to not get too intensely geeky, because I can go down that hole in my own sort of language. I'm not like a theory person. But anyway, so I tune the guitar down a whole step, and the song basically in that respect would exist in kind of C sharp major, basically. This being the first chord, which looks on this fretboard like an E flat, but because we're tuned down, it's a C sharp, because that's a tone below E flat. So I'm going to show you, before I get into the sort of nuts and bolts of the finger picking and the details, I'm going to show you how you would kind of strum this just as chords, because I think you can do that. You don't have to. I wanted to show people who maybe aren't deep into finger picking and sort of single lines and individual unique playing like that. I wanted to show you can actually just strum this song. So once you've tuned it down a whole step, you can put a capo on. I've got a nice springy squeezy capo here. You can get all sorts of capos. And I'm going to put it on the third fret, because that means that that first chord that I was playing is now a C chord. You can play it just as a C chord. Capos are fun and fantastic, because for whether you're a early player or whether you have been like playing forever, we all know or find out that you can easily kind of move through different keys by using a capo. So basically, with the capo on the third fret here and start and pretending like the song is in the key of C, looking at the chord shapes, this C chord would be your first chord of the song, and I guess the verse would go C, F, A minor, G, that would be your verse. So, from walking home and talking loads to C
seeing shows in evening clothes with you. From nervous touch and getting drunk to staying up and waking up with you.
So that would be a verse. And simpler in those kind of basic chord shapes. C, F, A minor, G. The only most kind of tricksy part of this song is the pre-chorus, and I still think the smartest way to do it, for it to sound right, is to go to the sort of finger-picked thing. What you would do is, you'd come from where your C chord is, you'd go here. So you'd go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 frets up, and you'd start there on the D string, and you'd make this shape. You'd get the D string there, 1, and then you get on the G string, and you'd cover the B string with that finger, and you'd go, kind of pick it in any fashion you want, and then that note on the D string there drops. So you're covering those three strings on the same fret there, and then it would drop again, and you keep those two fretted, and then it would go down one more time on the D string, like that. So your pre-chorus picked any way you want.
Now we're sleeping at the edge, holding something we don't need. All this delusion in our heads is gonna bring us to our knees.
And then it stops on that, and the last line of the pre-chorus, it just stops there, as you can see. And then your chorus comes in, and that's, the chords are similar to the verse chords. There's a couple extras, there's one extra, and they're in a different order. It starts on what looks like that F chord. So it would go,
come on, let it go.
And then to the C, and then A minor and G.
Just let it be. Why don't you be you?
Here we go to what looks like a D minor.
Why don't you be you?
To the C.
And I'll be me.
To the G.
Everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me.
Back to your verse, which looks like C, F, A minor. It's just a couple of rounds of what look like C, F, A minor, G. So I'm going to play, not to get too boring, but I'm going to play the song, and you can watch my hand, and I'm going to play it that simple version for you, and then we'll get into some more of the details of the riff. And all that other stuff, and the finger picking. So I guess it would go. And you know what, before I do that, I'm gonna do the most important thing in the game. I'm gonna take this thing, which is a tuner. I'm gonna clip it to the headstock of the guitar, and all those vibrations are gonna come into it. And it's gonna be able to tell me if the strings are in or out of tune. Top string's good, next one's decent. That G string's a little weird, because capos can sort of squeeze your strings and send them sharp sometimes. So it's always good to be in tune. One thing I've learned about a lot over the years is tuning and talking. It's a fine art. I'm not very good at it. Some people do it very well and are extremely interesting and funny. Not me, sorry about that. Anyway, here we go. This is the simple version, or probably one of the simplest versions of Let It Go. Just strumming out the basic chords rather than doing any of the finger picking and all of that stuff. So it would go like this.
From walking home and talking lows to seeing shows in evening clothes with you. From nervous touch and getting drunk to staying up and waking up with you. Now we're sleeping at the edge, holding something we don't need. All this delusion in our heads is gonna bring us to our knees. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. And why don't you be you? I'll be me, and I'll be me. From throwing clothes across the floor to teeth and claws and slamming doors at you. This is all we're living for. Then why are we doing it, doing it, doing it anymore? I used to recognize myself. It's funny how reflections change. When we're becoming something else, I think it's time to walk away. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. And everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. And why don't you be you? I'll be me. And I'll be me. Just don't belong. There's no force on earth can make it feel right. No, no. Oh, trying to push this problem up the hill when it's just too heavy to hold. I think now's the time to let it slide. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? Oh, and I'll be me. And everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. Let the ashes fall, forget about me. Come on, let it go, just let it be. And why don't you be you? Oh, and I'll be me. Yeah, I'll be me.
So that's it. That's basically how you do it. Really simple, just strumming out the basic chords. I realized before I went through that, I didn't talk to you about the middle eight. Apologies. But hopefully you followed it as it went by. It would start on what looks like D minor.
Trying to fit your hand inside of mine.
Then we go to the C, whatever that next lyric is. Sometimes we forget our lyrics. And then to the G, and then up to the A minor. And then we do all of that again.
Trying to push this problem up a hill when it's just too heavy to hold.
G, think now's the time to let it slide. A minor, and it would sort of rest on that A minor. And then you do the little breakdown chorus.
Come on, let it go.
So that would be the basic version of Let It Go if you're putting a capo. And you can move the fun of the capo, like I said, you can move the capo wherever you want and find out which key you sing best in, or whoever's singing, which key they sing best in. But every time you can take those basic chord shapes, you know, around the C and the F chord, A minor, G and all of that. And you can work it out and you can go and play it wherever you want, whenever you want. Just gonna look at my script again, 1 second. I said break it down, I said go through the tuning, talk about the key, talk about the basic chords. I wanted to tell you a little bit, this is for the geeks, this is for the people who are deep into the guitars, the guitar geeks like me. I'll tell you a little bit about my guitar. I got this guitar about 7 or 8 years ago. It is a 1966 Epiphone Century. If you can see it, there it is, in all its sort of simple glory. There's the headstock. I've just been through the wars a little bit. It's for a hollow body guitar. You can see with the F holes that it's a hollow body guitar. It's actually a pretty shallow guitar. It's not the thickest. It's not like a thick, deep hollow body like a lot of the hollow body electrics are. I like this one because it's shallow. It's lighter wood, and it's lighter because it's sort of shallow and there's not so much to it. It's got one pickup, just one P90 pickup. This is a Kinman Noiseless P90, because P90s are a kind of pickup that make quite a lot of noise a lot of the time. When there's certain lights on, certain frequencies start mixing and it all gets buzzy and weird. So this one isn't the original pickup, although I did use that for a long time, and eventually the poor thing just kind of gave up. I still have it, but it's in retirement. This pickup makes less noise if I'm playing under all sorts of different lights at festivals, maybe sometimes on TV shows and stuff like that. So it's just got the one pickup, and it's got a volume knob and a tone knob. This guitar, even more specifics about this as an electric guitar, is that it has a wooden bridge. It's just one bridge, one carved piece of wood. You can't move the different, what are called the saddles. The saddles are the things that hold each of the strings. This is just one thing. You can raise it and lower it, and you can move it back and forth, but you can't move them individually like you can on a lot of electric guitars. And this guitar better supports a wound G string. The G string here on most electric guitars is called a plain G string, and it usually feels a lot more like the B and the high E, but this one feels a lot more like the D string. It's got a wound string all around it, and you can't bend it as easy and all that stuff. So that is this guitar. And I guess, you know, writing songs like Let It Go and a lot of other songs of mine, it feels at times like an acoustic guitar. I can play it unplugged and I can hear it and it sounds great and it's loads of fun. And it sort of rattles and makes all these kind of acoustic, kind of hollow noises, but it also feels like an electric guitar because it's still sort of little enough that it's got kind of an electric guitar neck. So yeah, I wrote Let It Go on this guitar because you can get all intimate with it, but it still makes enough noise even when it's unplugged. As far as getting intimate and still being loud and being able to treat it like an electric guitar and all that stuff, and I play in lots of different ways, I do a lot of finger picking, I do a lot of stuff with a pick as well, that brings me smoothly onto, as I segue perfectly, onto what I want to say about the riffs in this song. So I've played you this song, I've played you Let It Go a couple of times here, and then some of you are going to know the original version from the record, and maybe have seen us play it live. Some of you might just know these sort of solo versions of it more. There's two pretty detailed parts to this, even the intro of this song. You've got the way that I play the chords, which is a root and a third, and then I leave the G string open the whole time. It kind of creates this drone note, which is kind of fun. It works, it bounces off all the different chords in the song. So I do this thing with these two fingers and my thumb. So I go. I'm gonna get in, I'm gonna zoom in here, check me out. So I'm gonna go, so it goes here, you can sort of follow the frets. There's the first fret right at the top there. And it comes all the way down, fifth fret, seventh fret. So I'm starting, the lowest note is on the eighth fret on the A string. Here's my fingers. God, phone screens are too small, aren't they? So that's what I'm doing. And then I'm going, and I'm just, the bass note moves on the A string, eighth fret. Wait a minute, sixth fret, I can't count. I can count to four, that's all you need in music, most of the time. Sixth fret, and then up to the 11th fret. And then we're jumping down to the low E string and we're going eighth fret, there he is, back to the sixth fret. And that's the bass notes of your chords, basically. And then so those guys are being hit once at the top of each chord. And then it's just about these two other guys. These two fingers are playing on the G string and the B string. And you combine all that and you get. And that's the gist for the intro and for the verse. And it's different as you work it out, like it's different versions of that that play around all the different chords. So that's the first chord. Second chord, third chord, fourth chord. And before we go on to, there's lots of other different parts of the song that do that, but before we do that, I'm going to show you, you got the pre-chorus is that different thing. Well, I showed you it earlier, which is the same kind of pattern, but does this thing. And you just want to fall down on the D string, the note just drops. And then you go into your chorus, which is like a reverse of the verse chord. You start on that second chord up here on the 11th fret. And back down to there. And then I send it all the way down. You can see there. And then you come back up here. It just goes, it's the 8th fret.
Come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. And I'll be me.
And then back to the verse or the reintro. So that's verse, pre, chorus. We'll do the middle 8 and then we'll jump onto the riff. The middle 8, again, is kind of like the verse and the chorus. It's those kind of shapes with the root, the open G string, and the third, always happening on the B string. But it starts here on the 8th fret.
Trying to fit your hand inside of mine. Well, I know it just don't belong.
Then I go up above, I go to the 13th fret.
There's no force on earth could make it feel right.
And up from the 4th, so yeah, 13th fret, 15th fret. You can see how that rolls. And it just repeats. So the last thing I want to show you about this song and how to play it is the riff that goes over the top of everything I've just played. So this is the intro chords, and then you have this riff that goes over the top. And this is, I'm trying to work out how best to show you. It goes like this. You get this finger involved. Hopefully that makes sense. It's just on the B string and the E string, the two highest strings. You can see how that goes. And you can kind of add all that finesse and flavor if you want to. You don't have to. So I don't have four hands and two guitars right now, which is really a shame, because if I did, of course, I'd show you that you put this underneath. And then over the top, you put. You put those two guys together and you get the intro and the outro. And all the bits in between to Let It Go. And there you have, basically, from start to finish, all of the chords and all of the tuning and all of the guitar parts to Let It Go. Thank you very much for being here. I really appreciate hanging out with you guys and showing you this. I hope it's been helpful. I would love to see how you get on. Send me videos and show me how you do. And I'd love to hear you singing it, and I'd love to see you playing it and hear you playing it. Get somebody else to play the other guitar part. If you've got friends, you know, anybody in the house at this point who wants to play the other part, give them a guitar and get learning and show me how you get on. I guess if everybody enjoyed this, then maybe I'll do some more. We'll see how it goes. Just give me a shout and let me know. In the meantime, wash your hands, stay safe. Right now, I think stay inside is the best move for everyone around the world, as we're being told. And yeah, I hope to see you soon. Love you guys. See you very soon. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.